Weather on Donner Pass is totally unpredictable. You never know what's gonna happen up there. Dumping 10 feet of snow in 2 days. That snow up there accumulates and it is heavy, wet snow. It's a lot heavier in water content and it requires some heavy duty equipment to get it out of there.
As long as the snow's coming down or the wind's blowing and causing that drifting snow to be a problem up there, they're not gonna stop clearing it away.
This whole wing that we're looking at right here, this whole big wing, it was originally set up as a ditch wing spreader. And it's going to be converted a fixed wing, so this whole wing will be made of a double wall construction and replaced on both sides of the machine. The two pieces of equipment that we're going to be working on that we've got a contractor that's going to basically rebuild the UP903031, which is the yellow spreader, and then the SPMW4031, which is the orange one. They will both have new operator cabs put on them. They will have the secondary cab that's behind the operator's cab put on them, because neither one of them had those. They will have locomotive controls put inside the operator cabs. They will have rotary windows, locomotive auxiliary generators applied to them so that they have power to drive the heating system that we're putting on them to get away from the old propane system. A new engine package, a six-cylinder engine package that drives that auxiliary generator and the hydraulic system on them. Roughly, we have a little over 2 months to get them completed, and it is going to be a challenge. There's a lot of work to be done, but I believe it's doable if we get it all coordinated together.
They got a long way to go.
Some of the structure and adding additional support.
There are electricians, there are welders, there are plumbing guys. It's exciting to be here. Woo!
Things that some of the other people that are helping project out are doing or redoing all the air system. These are a new, more compact style battery, all part of making these units self-sufficient.
The steel is real rough and porous, so the roller packs it into all the pits and grooves and helps seal it up and get the proper mill for the spec.
The new cab will weigh almost 6,000 pounds.
The Deutz unit is an air-cooled engine rather than a water-cooled engine. It also has better fuel economy than the original engine. Even pulling all the extra power and with the extra capacity, the higher horsepower range would still have better fuel economy. It's a pretty solid unit.
You have actually caught me at a very high anxiety moment. We got fuel from the line into the fuel system. There's the injector lines, throttle linkage, throttle handle. We've hooked up the batteries already. We've got the chain link attached to the generator. Let's give it a whirl, shall we? We've primed up. We're in neutral. Here's our engine start panel. Looks like it's ready to start, so right behind you, you're gonna hear this. Doesn't get any better than that. That, sir, is a beautiful thing. I'm going to engage the generator. We're spinning. The generator field switch is coming up. We should hear a difference in the generator. All right, it's loading. We're charging. 74.8, we'd like to see 75 volts. Charging the batteries at 32 amps and going down, which means they're taking a charge very nicely. It's a monster. That's a lot of equipment right there to make this thing hum, but it really put life into it.
We had different obstacles as far as the climate is concerned, but we've been out here in the rain dealing with it.
Run the oxyacetylene hoses down this pipe, through here, through that pipe there, over there, and then the hoses will be protected. And then if they need a torch, they'll just reel it off that reel.
Doing air brake tests, we can lose up to 5 pounds in 1 minute with the air brakes cut out. It hasn't lost one bit since I cut it out.
This was delivered this morning, so they actually made the application today on the 18th, the last day when they're supposed to be done, so we're still adding pieces.
It's huge. I mean, when you think that this was a frame a couple of months ago, this was a shell, all that wire had to go into it, all the piping, and you know, you've been keeping up with the piping as you've gone along, and there's so much little pieces that had to fit perfectly together to put life back into it, and it's happening today. So it's pretty exciting.